Hi everyone, I'm here with Sandy Donnelly today from DBC Health Retreats. So Sandy, in a pre-COVID world, what are you normally doing?
Oh, in a pre-COVID world, when was that? Let me think back to the pre-COVID world. Well, things have changed a lot since COVID has hit us all. And I would usually be running my health retreats in nice, sunny, warm locations, mountainous, by the sea, and with travel restrictions, etc. Over the last year or so, it's just been impossible. So retreats have just not happened. People have been nervous about booking. I've been nervous about booking venues in case it's not going to go ahead. So that's what would have been happening. We would be away now.
But you've decided to go virtual instead. Tell us about that.
So we've got to adjust with what's happening in the world, and we don't know how long this will go on for. So I'm so passionate about my retreats. I can't just let them go, and I don't know when they will resume again back to normal. So I think the way forward was to go virtual. It was suggested by a friend of mine a few months ago, actually, and I couldn't figure out in my head how could this work. You know, we're usually in a beautiful place all together, we've traveled, we've packed, you know, the whole part of the process, and suddenly you're in your home, your kitchen. So with a lot of thought, I put it together and thought, well, let's give this a go and see how it could work. And in a way, so we held our first one just this weekend gone, which was very successful, fortunately, and it was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun also. But what it's gave people now, instead of them rocking up to my retreat, I still want them to rock up to my retreat when it happens. But instead of that, it's gave them that hands-on approach that they've been physically involved in the creation of making juices, of energy balls, of our healthy meal. Mm. They're hands-on. So educationally wise, it's been quite informative for them to be able to learn this process. And the feedback I've been getting is that they're more likely to continue it now because they it's in their heads. They know what's been put in here. They physically had to do it and then taste it and know what it's like as well.
So what can people expect on your treat? So you talked about juicing and you've talked about preparing meals. So what else?
So I'm running weekends. So it's over a weekend. And instead of taking up like the people's whole weekend, it runs on the Saturday and the Sunday for 2 hours in the morning, 2 hours in the afternoon. So people have still got the middle of the day, a big majority of the day to still, if they're still doing things. So it's not their entire weekend. And it's a detox and cleanse. So they start with, I'm guiding them every step of the way. We started at 8:30 a.m. in the morning. I prepped them before and said, have the certain ingredients, the juices and vegetables prepared so that we could all go through, instead of starting to have to peel and chop, they already had that pre-prepared, that we would go for the juicing process.
Oh, good idea.
So we made 7 or 8 juices together. And along the way, they're learning the benefits of the vegetables and the combinations also, which has been really interesting. So juicing is one big part of it. So, and understanding the benefits of juicing versus smoothies also. So we did tap into the smoothies and had a smoothie on the next day. So day one is about more detox and cleansing the system. We then continued with a workshop, a condition your nutrition workshop, which I kind of make it fun rather than being me droning on. They don't want to be just listening to me. I make it into a kind of a bit of a quiz, fill the blanks. What are you understanding? What do you know about this? Just to help them build their whole nutritional plan. And then we do Pilates. We did power Pilates, so a bit of heart raising Pilates in the morning. And in the evening, then some meditation. So day one is just a detox and cleanse full of juices. And we made a healthy soup, a vegetable soup together also.
And do you actually need to have a juicer or can you do it with a blender?
To be honest, there was a couple of people just with a blender, but a juicer is highly recommended because the difference in the nutritional benefits from a juicer and a blender are quite big. Mm. So the few people who did use the blender, I don't think they benefited as much than with a juice. They were a little, because the smoothie's thicker, the juice, you can just, you've got these beautiful colors, knowing they're full of all these nutrients. So a juicer is recommended.
Fantastic. And what happens on day two?
So day two was more about boosting your immunity and a bit of gratitude meditation involved. So we started our day making a smoothie. So again, it was like, look, taste the difference. You know, what do you think about the juices compared to the smoothies? We carried on our day then with a high intensity interval training session. So they got their hearts raised. So that was involved also, which tired them out then for a few hours throughout the day. And then when we returned, we were making, actually we made them earlier, we made some healthy snacks, some energy balls. And this was quite interesting because when people look on at these, they think, oh, these are so difficult to make. I could never do this myself. And when you show them hands-on how easy, how quick it is to make and the benefits of such a healthy, natural, no sugar, natural sugar snack, people get quite excited by this. And then in the evening, when everybody returned, it was the final part, the fourth part of the weekend. People were all revved up, you know, they were all excited about all of the last 2 days. And by then we've made friends as well. You've made these nice connections, and particularly some of the ladies who are on their own, they're not having any interaction with other people. It's a nice, healthy interaction to have together. So we started with gratitude meditation, which was very brief, but it was just all about reflecting on what we are grateful for. Basically, it might be a tough time out there, but we still have a lot to be thankful. And I don't like to go too deep, hairy fairy into anything like this, because I like to keep it that people will remember and it's going to stick with them, not that me going on and on that they think, oh, that was a bit long-winded. Instead, they've taken like the really nice bits of it out of there. And then we made a lovely cauliflower rice dinner together, nice. Which was, again, so many people said, oh, I've heard about the cauliflower rice, I just don't know how to do it. And again, seeing how simple it is to make this dish with everyday ingredients, the whole meal is very cost effective. It doesn't cost very much, yet it's so full of nutrients and very tasty. So the process of making that from start to finish was quite long. But in between, you know, we are all talking, people are sharing their ideas with me, and they're like, can we substitute this for this? They're teaching me things as well as me teaching them things. It's, you know, it's not all about me. And then we all sat down and we ate together, which was really, really nice. It was like having our farewell kind of final meal together, healthy meal. And we ended there. So today then, it was just about me. So it's the next day. It finished yesterday. Me still showing them some support that they will continue this journey, which I hope they will.
Fantastic. So is it for both men and women?
So it's mainly women seem to sign up. We did have one gentleman this weekend with his wife, which I thought was very nice that they were doing this together, because they eat together, they do all everything together. He opted out for some of the Pilates, which was absolutely fine. because he chose to go for a walk and do his own activity, which was also fine. So it is open to everyone, to men and to women. I just find, you know, more women tend to book on. But, you know, I would really encourage, especially couples, single men, it's open to everyone.
Fantastic. And when is the next retreat? Because I'm going on it. I booked on it.
I know. I'm very excited to have you on board, Rachel. The next one is in February. We are in February now, 20 to the 21st. So now I'll have more experience to run it. So look, I'm looking forward to the next one.
Fantastic. And how much is it?
It is £75 for the weekend. And what's something I'd like to emphasize about this, as I've said previously, there's a couple of other virtual retreats out there, and you know, they're a lot more expensive. they do provide juices, you know, they are delivered to you. So for convenience, I think it's great. But then you're losing that aspect of the educational side of it, of learning to do it yourself. And to me, that's part of the process, because how will you ever learn if you're just handed something? You're never going to know. It's never going to be in there in your mind. And another key thing is I like to keep my groups fairly small because I can't personalize it otherwise. No. I can't be one-on-one speaking to somebody if they want to ask me a question and my screen's full of numerous people. So if we've just got 10 people here, I can speak to each and every person. I think it's quite special to keep it like that. I want them to have a personal experience that I can answer any questions directly.
Yes, because these other virtual retreats, they're up in the hundreds, aren't they, of people attending them. So yes. You just don't get that personal service at all.
Or 500 people, which, okay, great number for making lots of money. Of course it is on that side of things. Mm-hmm. But you're never going to get that interaction, that direct interaction, which is what a lot of people who are, whatever their reasoning for doing these retreats. Mm. It may be weight loss. It may be just healthier living. It may be because they're struggling with some kind of medical issues and they just want a healthier living lifestyle or to change for the family, whatever it may be. You know, you want to be there to be able to answer these questions directly to them.
Excellent. So if people want to join your next retreat in February, and actually, are you running any more after that? Have you got any dates in?
Yes, I have in March. So the plan is to run one once a month. As I said, we don't know how long lockdown will continue for. But even when we are out of lockdown, I'd still like to continue with this because, you know, some people, they may have children that they can't get away on my retreat. Some people may just, they might be very nervous in the future about traveling for the foreseeable future. So it's something I will continue. And then if it becomes very popular, you know, I will increase to two a month because I really enjoy doing them also.
It's a fantastic idea. So if people want to sign up, and as I said, I've signed up for the February one, which I'm very excited about. And I really do need it. I need a bit of a detox. And it's funny because we know how to do all this stuff, but it's just nice being told what to do.
Yes. It is. And it is. I sometimes feel like I am being a teacher, but I also want to be a friend. I want to be that person who's there to answer the questions. So when some of the guests were, you know, messaging me, can I get this? I can't seem to find this. It's like, oh, it's fine. You know, we can substitute this with that. It's very easy to adapt it as well. As you said earlier though, Rachel, I think the one thing, because I did say, you know, you can use a blender. You would need to just liquidize it a little bit more, add some water, but you're not going to get the same benefits as you would from the juicing because the juicing, the nutrients go directly into the system, the blood cells, whereas with, and the fibers extracted and taken away from it. So, but with a smoothie, you're including the fiber, the fibers and the nutrients, but it's going to be a slower, that it's going into your system.
Yeah.
So there are the differences. So a juicer is recommended, but something which it was nice, some of the people on board were sharing also said, they'd looked on Gumtree and Facebook and found juicers because there's so many people who buy a juicer, don't really know what to do with it or can't be bothered to them, which is a shame because they've not got that understanding, education, understanding of the huge benefits, particularly now, and are able to buy them, you know, which are new in a box still for like £20 or something. Yeah. So it's worth investing in a juicer. I mean, if there's anything I would advise anybody to get, if they say, what should I really have in my life? And it's like, you should have a juicer. You should, you know, everybody should own a juicer, especially now with the current situation, with coronavirus. I mean, to boost your immunity, there's no better way than to fill yourself with numerous nutrients from fruit and vegetables. And it's the best way. For your kids, for yourself, for your partners, for anybody, if you can. rather than a shop-bought one, you can make your own a lot cheaper and fresh.
Yes, more nutritional. So if people want to join the retreat, where do they have to go? And I'll also put...
They can go directly to my website, which is dbchealthretreat.com, or email me, sandy@dbchealthretreat.com. And I would welcome anybody on board. And with any questions, if there are any medical questions, you know, just ask me and I can adapt most things.
Fantastic. Well, I'm looking forward to it, as I say, in February. And if anybody's got any questions, please contact Sandy. Her details will be at the end of this recording. So thank you, Sandy, and see you again soon.
Thank you, Rachel.